Butt Vice. It's a game on Steam. That's pretty much all I know about
it. It's the robot version of Miami Vice.
Hey everybody, it's Pembroke W. Corky, and I'm here with...
You, Bunny.
And after the disaster that was Yojo Simulator, we're playing Butt Vice.
Hopefully it lasts longer.
It's gotta be better. I mean... I can't imagine it being worse.
Missed some sweetness in the 80s, but you didn't miss a lot, Kelsey.
You missed the NES and the SNES, I'd say that's a big miss.
Yeah, but they still had those in the N64 era.
It's time to relax and enjoy the ending while having a...
Nuking the hell out of a giant alien head. I can live with that.
Oh my god, this has dubbing.
No, not now!
Come on!
What is this?
Oh no.
My dear Bot City inhabitant.
I'm sure it's a bad guy.
Aside all other interactive entertainment offers and listen to my words. I am very pleased to announce that I have taken control of the Tamanaka Plaza building, and I'm going to make it disappear.
Oh, so it's a magician. Nice.
My paltry demand of 100 billion bot coins
met.
However, it is my guess that those incompetent illiterate
leaders... Is that anything like Bitcoins?
...you revere will not have access Bitcoin to my request. A shame
Bitcoin
if so,
worth anything.
For the amount is non-negotiable.
I don't know either.
I cordially
and why did he mispronounce it?
Heroics. Simply pay
look at him,
his
eyes are really weird.
You
might have
casting its majestic shadow.
He's also sure doing a lot of naughty.
My proposal is unjust and does not take into account your meager concerns. Please, declare as such to my most faithful and robotic minions.
Like we're watching a really bad anime dub.
Virtually every corner of this city.
You're not hearing him talk. It sounds like...
Yes, I am.
Oh. I guarantee you will receive the treatment.
You said it was dubbed, so I wanted to hear what the hell is going on.
Oh, and one more thing for those of you who are fans of the theatrics.
That laugh.
This is looking really bad. What a disaster.
Yeah, no, it causes to miss the end of the game. So, can we shoot stuff now?
My name is Aaron Saver.
We're playing Aaron from Game Grumps? Wow.
But at 28 years old, fate had other plans.
That Wheel of Fortune yesterday was something else.
6 months ago, while pursuing the Wild Fox, a criminal gang led by...
Only the guest star landed on Lose a Turn and,
I lost my partner
bankruptcy.
And my right arm in a failed operation.
I don't know, I always have a problem now, watching game guest scrumps because the guests never seem to... They're not... They always seem to, like, interrupt a lot, not really... I don't know, it just doesn't feel like...
This one was a lot better, I felt, than the others. That's why I felt like they had more of a kindred spirit there playing games with them.
Even if one of them is now
and can actually relate to their conversation more than the other
time
people.
For justice has passed. Cool. Today,
Serious Rainbow's playing Death Road to Canada? I wish I had that game. That game looks crazy awesome.
I need to get that game.
Come on. There's no time.
You need to get that game and stream it, Pam.
Someone wants to buy it for me, I will. Oh, the way her legs bend do not look accurate. Hey, you moved my box. There we go. Alright. Let's explain how to play. Okay. I got that. Cover press up. Oh, I admit. Down. Oh well. Enemy bullets won't hit you until... Okay. That's cool. B to roll. You do realize I changed my controls game, so none of these are probably accurate.
You just want to play Death Road to Canada so you can run around at the Wienermobile.
The faster you press, the faster you shoot. Well, that's pretty self-explanatory. You can also hold down for automatic shooting.
You've got no way out!
Oh, that's helpful. I can change weapons too. Nice.
Yep, I'm pretty certain I know who Waspinator is. So basically, it's like a 2D.
It's kind of like
straightforward.
What?
Oh, it's reminded me a lot of what is that? When you played with what's her name?
I blow up like a Mega Man. What? I have to go through the tutorial again?
Oh, it's not Wild Arms. It's reminding me of.
Reminds me of kind of reminds me of like games like the ball, except in an overhead.
Mm-hmm. It's the stuff at the bottom that's reminding me of that other game. I'm gonna flip through your YouTube and see what the fuck it's called.
I know.
What the hell it's called? Metal Slug, that's it.
Oh, I need to cancel that. Well, my problem was I was goofing off in the tutorial because they weren't expecting it to really be, like, matter. That's my own fault, I guess.
That explosion should have taken them out.
You'd think.
Flame gun.
I just love the guy announcing what gun you're switching to.
Now Master Game Grumps moveset, enjoy the adventure.
The narrator that does your gun switching is awesome. Waspinator, we get it!
What's he saying?
He keeps saying, you know, you need to speedrun this or else you won't get to the end. You won't ever get to the last level. It's like, we get it. We like to take our time to get the hang of a game first.
Oh, we got bosses.
Grenade.
in a cupboard.
Yeah. And he's all like, gotta shoot fast.
Oh no, I Mega Man'd.
Action.
That's good. Nice. Game's a challenge, I'll give it that. Great, it's also that, like, you gotta kinda get the hang of the mechanics thing. Cause it's not like every other... Since I can't just run all over the place like in any other video game. I'm not sure I understand the point of the saber, though.
You'll get it handy at some point.
Okay, I think I'm getting the hang of this now.
Those comments are bad. Say hello to my little friend. What a thing you want to hear before sex.
Hey.
I'd say the music's pretty good for this.
Yeah. Yeah. There we go. Got you.
Bam!
I think I've got the hang of this now. Got my killer anime here.
I'm destroying my cover! I need that!
Okay, I think I've got the hang of this now. Oh.
Man, Aaron really changed the way he looks after he got popular in Game Grumps.
The hair's kind of the same, he just made it purple. And got dressed. Oddly, I'm not very surprised by that. I bet Susie was all into that too.
Also got a cybernetic arm.
Oh, that was all that was a rave back then. That's rage in the future. Oh, there's no jumps in it. That isn't better by, that I can't dodge from, the cover.
This also kind of reminds me of Chrono Trigger in a way.
That's it. Maybe.
The graphics kind of remind me of it.
Ah.
No way, Baxter Stockman bot.
This saber really doesn't help me much. It's like, oh, I can hit things close to me with a powerful hit, but it also makes it to where I can't see them shoot me right in the face.
What? You want to see things actually hit you in the face? That's crazy, Tom. Yeah.
I know what you secretly want, do you?
What is that?
You want them to release episodes of Doozy Bots.
No.
Nobody knows what that is.
Comedy action series coming in the fall of 1991. Hey kids, get ready for...
Doozy Bots! I think I should put the link in chat.
Yeah, go ahead and put the link for that in chat. That was something I'd never heard of, and I don't know if I'm better to found out about it.
Like I told you this morning, it's like I found that was on one of the sites I frequent lately on his comic, and he's like, you know, this is unrelated, but here. And I'm like, I just gotta show this to him. It's just one of those old cartoons we didn't need, or I'm quite happy we didn't get. I quite like Gundam the way it is, thank you very much.
Oh, it's not just Gundam, it's SD Gundam. Action.
Yeah.
It looks like they were trying to do what, like, Transformers did, which is, like, you know, take an unrelated Japanese storyline and make it into something completely American. Which, surprisingly, became even more popular than the original thing it came from in Japan. Needless to say, that didn't go very far, and I'm kind of glad that's the case.
Yeah, well, at least four kids got Yu-Gi-Oh! Stripped. Got, you know, all the shows they were doing stripped from them.
Yeah. Aren't they... Did they go out of business or something?
I don't know. I think what... I don't remember what exactly happened. Just they finally got all the shows... Like, all the shows they were doing stripped from them. Like, nope, you're not doing this anymore.
Yeah, because I know Nintendo themselves set up their own company to do the Pokemon dubs now.
Yeah.
There.
Stage clear. Yeah, everybody remembers the One Piece, but nobody remembers the Yu-Gi-Oh, which is actually pretty decent. Original Yu-Gi-Oh was not that bad.
There's always Sonic X.
That was decent. Weird, but decent.
Oh, they did the, they're responsible for the, 2000, the 2K, Ninja Turtle cartoon being a thing. So, that's something worth them being alive for.
Yeah. All I can say is, if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't have Yu-Gi-Oh! Bridge, so... I like Little Kuriba.
Yeah, I never really watched Yu-Gi-Oh! Much, so I don't really have an opinion on it.
Yeah, he did a few music videos I really get out of based on the Yu-Gi-Oh! Franchise. But he is kind of... Well, partly, I think I want to say he was partly responsible for the card games on motorcycles meme. Yeah, the original Yu-Gi-Oh! Movie was just one giant card advertisement. I think that door leads to danger, Pim.
I think you might be onto something there. Oh, it's a forklift as a boss? Interesting.
Oh, I never knew forklifts were that dangerous. Yeah, that's
what dangerous part though. Well, the worst part is I can't, like... Oh, I should have probably tried rolling. I guess I have unlimited lives in this game. Well, I guess in games like this, that's kind of... since they're not actual arcade games, there's no point in giving you, like, the mid lives.
I kind of dare to say otherwise, Kelsey.
Oh?
Well, he's saying, you know, well, it's hard to make compelling narratives out of card games from death. They make it pretty interesting in later Yu-Gi-Ohs, let me tell you.
Yeah, like they do it on Motorcycle. Seriously, that was other things.
Card games on motorcycles!
Card games on motorcycles!
PCDs. And other news, famous YouTuber victim of defective forklift hurt. And you're supposed to roll away from the bullets, not into them.
Why does everything look like an animal, too? Did this guy go to the Dr. Wily School of
robot
creation?
Well, he certainly didn't go to the Dr. Robotics School of Robots. I mean, you don't have Warbot or or anything.
This thing's tough. It's fun, but it's tough. It's also hard to find things to talk about. Unfortunately.
Oh, there's plenty to talk about. Like, there's no bubble dragons in this.
Playing it. Isn't that one?
Well, technically you're behind the screen, not actually in the game.
I think it just requires you to do like too many things at once that one of the issues. I still want to know how that guy got that wheelchair over the field goal.
I don't know. There wasn't like any thrusters or anything on his wheelchair. He just did a hop with his wheelchair and somehow got over the field goal. It's like, I don't understand the physics of that.
Nah, it's like... It's like the guy who did with the skateboard is pretty, like, you know, bullshit enough, but, you know... It's easy to hand wave that. The wheelchair, on the other hand, not so much.
Well, at least it's physically possible with the skateboard. I mean, you have to get some serious air, you know, speed up, you know, launch into the air shit, but, you know. I'm saying it's physically possible, just not the way he did it.
Yeah.
Beast says, well, at least this game's fun, right?
Yeah.
Well, maybe we should take a break from this and stream, you know, some, like, Mega Man 2 or something. don't know. Hey, you're called in. Oh, we should stream sometime.
What?
Final Fight.
That would be cool.
Not on Fightcade.
Yeah, it's on Fightcade. I just need to reset up my Fightcade though.
Right. I think that'd be a fun game to play next year.
Yeah. Bloody heck.
It has one of the few people with my actual real name that I actually find, you know, cool.
Guy?
Yes.
He's the fastest character in the game.
Yep. I mean, Guy Fieri's alright, but, you know, he's just a foodie. I'm still not actually convinced he knows actually how to cook. All he ever does is go around eating everything.
Well, you know. Nothing says, I got nothing. I was going to say something. Nothing says, like, hungry, like, eating a steak out of a trash can.
What, did he suddenly become a raccoon or something?
Seems that way. Seems that happens with anybody who's a fighting game character.
I know, we need a beat 'em up Castlevania where you can go around to Simon Belmont and break things. Boiled chicken!
Well, they did have that Castlevania fighting game on the Wii. What was it, Castlevania Judgment?
I don't remember.
I hear it's not so good. Yeah, I don't know. This game's okay. I'm just not getting into it, I guess.
Oh, probably because you're getting your ass kicked multiple times.
Maybe. I don't know. I give Bot Vice. Now, this is probably going to be the random Steam stream at this rate. I give Bot Vice. I give Bot Vice 3 out of 5 machine guns.
I'll give it 3 out of 5 flamethrower.
Alright.
Or as the game calls it, flame gun.
Flame gun. Yeah.
Well, I think at this point, anything's better than Yoju Simulator.
And that's for sure. Hey, look, they have a Subway restaurant.
Okay. Well, that's awful nice of them. Don't have any good subs.
Yeah, I think that's enough game playing for me right now. I'm gonna go eat something.
Alright, take care, dude.
See ya.
Yeah. Take care, chat.
Bye. See ya.
I love makeup. Oh my god! Ah!
You have to save her!